Changzhou is one of the towns leading the way in an astounding change in the Chinese way of life. In 1980, their government announced, after careful study, the State Council deems it necessary to launch a crash program to control our population growth. For the next 30 years at least, all couples may only have one single child each. The Chinese have been very swift in implementing this policy throughout China. Changzhou was chosen to serve as a model to show others how to make the policy work. They began here 4 years ago. As you look around this town, you simply don't see anyone with more than one child. How do they stop second babies being born? What happens to the people who get pregnant and try to keep it secret? Mrs. Chang Kang Mai tried to keep a pregnancy secret. She wanted a second child. She had it aborted 2 months ago. The woman behind her in blue, Mrs. Sai Yu Chin, is the family planning worker of Chang Kang Mai's brigade. She had the job of persuading her to have the abortion. Chang already had her one child, a son. But 10 months ago, Chang decided to become pregnant again. She hid the pregnancy until at 7 months it was noticed. Then she went to her mother's house 20 miles away. Sai Yu Chin followed to bring her back.
在里头走不少辰光，工作回来呢，已经7个月够了嘞。那么肚皮越来越大，我新娘呢带到那这个站起来呀，是人家也担心，给大哥家里边呢，通过我几次走工作，走工作，我来走不少次，我爸一次都来，我大带了，大带长主任，工厂的主任也都来走工作，政策。 当时没想养过，但是想养的，但是到后末来，后末来了过去做这思想工作嘛，要过来引产嘞。所以，我过来以前呢，也同样过来给内产自己。再好呢，人家话是接着了，是吧？当时人家思想不通，是因为我家头个月份再内产，再要接着呢，恐怕身体不好。可是现在我过来同意他过来，过来养了一个自己，又再去接着。
The government's rush to this stringent policy is because of the coming crisis. China's population was just a few million at 200 BC. It steadied at 50 million at 400 AD. Then it began to grow after 1500, reaching half a billion in 1949, the time of the Communist Revolution. The nation was asked to limit their families to two in 1971. It was when the population reached 1 billion that Peking announced that each couple could only have one child. But even this stringent rule doesn't stop the growth. Two-thirds of the Chinese are under 24, have yet to marry and have their single child. So by the year 2000, even at one child per family, it's an inevitable 1.2 billion. But if the policy fails and family size stays at just over two children, it's 1.4 billion. The extra equals the whole population of the USA. The plan is now to maintain the one-child policy for 100 years so that the population will halve. Changzhou is the Chinese dream. It's had a huge investment of government money to develop its factories. Workers must have their factory's permission to get married. They have to have received instruction in family planning and passed a written test. They have to be over 24 years old. When they get their permission, they're told by Dr. Chun, the family planning officer, when they can try for a child. In each team of 16 women, there's a telltale. She's constantly alert for anyone who might be pregnant or feeling broody. In this case, though, she's reporting that someone with permission to try for a baby has become pregnant. We asked her, doesn't the fact that she's always watching her workmates, always asking them about their periods and so on, doesn't that make for resentment? Mrs. Zhao Zhujian married 3 years ago. Recently, she asked to have a child and is being given permission to try it. The card is the official permission to become pregnant. Without one, a baby can't be registered. Zhao Zhujian is part of a large family, a way of life the new policy will radically alter. Zhao lives close to her mother. The whole family usually eat their evening meal together. That's her five brothers and sisters, together with their husbands and wives and their single children. Tonight's meal is to be special to celebrate Zhao's permission. Most Chinese are members of such a family. Parents depend on their children to look after them in their old age. And because girls always go and live with the husband's family, it's been essential to have sons. That's why when a girl is born, the couple are often pressurized by their parents to ignore the rules and try again for a son. What will China be like in two generations? None of the youngsters here will have brothers or sisters. The children of these children will have no first cousins, no siblings, just two aging parents. If you have one child, they do their best to see it stays healthy. There are regular medical checkups, also free. If you have a one-child certificate, the factory provides a free nursery. It's well-staffed to give the very best nursery education. If a person were to break the promise and have a second child, then they would have to pay back all these benefits the first child has had. It could easily cost a year's salary. Mrs. Liu Kaiping lives 15 minutes away in the old part of town. As she enters her street, she comes under the sharp eyes of the granny police. Granny Wu is responsible for the 16 families who live around this end of the street. Liu Kaiping is one of her families.
Yang
The plan is now to maintain the one-child policy for 100 years so that the population will halve. A lot of effort is being made to get the people to understand what the growth is doing to their living standards. That's why success in the model towns like Changzhou is so important, and why the city officials here are so determined to stop second children. It's very rare to see a government trying to deal with problems 30 years ahead, but the Chinese are saying this. If the population were to halve to 700 million, they would have twice today's living standards. If it steadies at 1 billion, they can continue to keep people fed and housed. At 1.5 billion, they see a descent to poverty. Above that, severe hardship. Above 2 billion, it's a fight for food. If we were faced with this, what would be the most civilized way we could deal with it? First, explain and convince everyone there is a problem. Then, limit births. And finally, ensure the rules are applied equally to all. That's what the Chinese are doing. It is harsh, but is there an alternative?
Britain today.
That is really cheap.